Hey, thanks for joining us. This is Wendy. Wendy, you've been having some vertigo, right?
Yes.
And it seems to happen with turning over in bed?
Yeah, almost every time, yes.
Which is kind of classic for benign paroxysmal positional vertigo that we've talked about on videos before, where I'll go through the four words. Benign, meaning it's not dangerous. Positional, meaning it's based on body position or head position turning. Paroxysmal just means it's intermittent. And vertigo referring to the illusion of movement. The eyes go like this, and so it looks like things are moving like you just got off the merry-go-round.
Okay.
You described that earlier.
Yes.
So we're gonna do the Dix-Halpike maneuver first to test for it,
okay. And
then continue into the Epley maneuver in order to make it go away.
Okay.
So when we do it, we'll have you lie back rather quickly.
Okay.
Head tilted back and turn toward me. I'll position myself to be right where your eyes will be. Here we go. All right, that's perfect. You're in exactly the right place and your eyes are perfectly still in this direction. Oh, I see it. Do you feel it?
Mm-hmm.
It's kicking in.
Mm-hmm.
So let's see if that will stop.
Yeah, it's spinning.
Okay. Not terribly intense, though,
no,
compared to what it was at home.
No.
Yeah, and from looking at it, it looks like it's not that intense. And if it's still going, I don't know if it's still going.
It's slowed down. It's stopping.
Open your eyes bright as you can, big as you can. So for the Epley maneuver, we're going to have you do something here. I need you to carefully turn your head to the other side.
Okay. Slowly?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
And how's that feel?
It doesn't feel bad.
Doesn't feel bad. Okay. We're going to have you stay here for about...
I can feel it a little bit.
Just a little bit. For about 30 seconds. Okay, so start to turn onto your left side of your body. I'm going to try to pull a pillow out from underneath you if I can. Oh, ideally, your head would continuously touch the table. And turn even more, tilt your head even more, and then give me another 30 seconds.
Okay.
How are you feeling?
Not too bad.
And then the next step will be just simply to have you sit up, moving from where you are toward your right. So we're gonna have your feet go off the other side, in front of you on the table there.
10 seconds up. Hmm? You're good.
All right, so move your legs up here so they can go off the edge of the table and come up sideways. How do you feel?
Just a little sensation of it.
A little bit. So is that the same maneuver that you saw online?
No, she had you kneel on the floor and put your head back and then bring your head forward onto the floor.
All right. I'm going to print out some instructions that show a diagram of how to go through this
okay. So
that you can do it at home if you need to.
Okay.
But this is the correct way of doing it. So and for you, it's first you do lie with your head turned to the right because that's what triggers it.
Right.
Then you turn over to the opposite side.
Okay.
Then you turn your head down to the table and then you sit up. Not that many steps to it.
Right. Yeah, I can feel like just the weirdness in my head is all I'm feeling right now.
Okay. We can do it again if you want.
We can do it again. Try.
You want to do it again? Yeah. Okay, let's get the pillow back. So this is going to be a second Epley maneuver. And on this one, let's start so that your feet can be more on the table. Let's scoot you up this way even more. You remember how to do it, right? The head is back and tilted and turned to the right. So go ahead. And let the head, so that part of your head that's touching the table, there's a little bit, but not much.
A little bit, not much.
That part of your head that's touching the table, I want it to stay in continuous contact with the table.
Okay.
So give me 30 seconds. So turn your head to the other side now.
Keep going on my side?
Not all the way over, just, not that far, just there. It's only 90 degrees at a time.
Okay.
And then after 30 seconds, we'll go over to the nose touching the table. Again,
okay. Keeping
that head in contact with the table the whole time. And now turn to have your nose touching the table. Yeah, you kind of get over on your side there. I'm going to put my hand here because you're... she's just kind of looking into the table now. 30 seconds of this, and then we'll have you sit up sideways. All right, so put your feet forward, or your knees forward. There you go. And roll sideways, looking straight ahead. How are you?
Okay. I mean, I feel a little bit, but...
Yeah. Is it better than last time?
Yes.
So progressively, it does get better as you do it. Like I said, we had one video where a patient completely had resolution with just doing this one time. Usually you have to do it, sometimes it takes days. Rarely will it go into weeks. That's okay. Rare that it goes that long. And you didn't even need this.
Yeah, that's pretty shocking. I tried it myself.
Because it's getting better. It's extinguishing.
Yes, exactly.
Yeah. And this does get better as you go along. Even without the exercises, generally just life, walking around, your head moving, the problem gets resolved. And we think what's going on is that there's a little calcification inside of the inner ear that's kind of going against the flow in a fluid environment, giving your brain false information, false messages of movement, rotational movement, so that when you rotate a certain way, the whole system gets knocked off and your brain doesn't like getting conflicting information. It's getting one message from the inner ear that you're moving a certain way because it's messed up. But your eyes are telling you something else, and your whole body sense, you know, knowing where you are in space, the body knows when you're sitting or standing or turning, even with your eyes closed and even without the information from the inner ear. So when those things don't add up, the body feels really, really badly.
Yes.
It lets you know something's wrong.
Yes.
And we're gonna get those things matched up again. The body tries to make up for it by having the emotion of the eyes match what the ear is, inner ear is telling it. And that's why the eyes do that.
Oh, okay.
It's trying to synchronize the two. And so you get saccadic eye movements.
And I did not know that.
Sorry you had to experience that. Thank you, Wendy, so much
for
being a part of this.
No, thank you
for joining us. And if you're not already a subscriber, please do subscribe. If you want to see some behind the scenes material, you can be a patron on Patreon. Until next time, Dr. Mark Vaughan and Wendy telling you to stay in good health.